This will be the whole episode, just me here breathing, almost vomiting right here.
Counter offer.
I can't.
That's what I think is fair.
Yeah, I know. No, it's a great piece.
Throw it at me.
All right,
I'm Zack Ryder.
Donnie Wahlberg tweeted me back last night. Can you believe it?
Wait, what?
And I'm Curt Hawkins.
Tell your story walking, Christopher.
Go.
We're gonna scour the world looking for toys.
We don't know exactly what we're looking for.
We're gonna find some holy grails, and we're also gonna find some things we don't want. Either way, we're gonna figure it out.
Hello everyone, and welcome to another edition of Zack and Curt Figure It Out Today. We're in Phoenix, Arizona at the Collector's Marketplace.
This desert oasis boasts impressive inventory of toys from every genre. We're gonna do some damage in this store today.
Yeah, and today is a very special day. We usually walk into these stores blind.
My box!
What are you doing?
All right, just keep talking.
All right, we usually walk into these stores blind. We don't know what we're looking for, what we're gonna find, but today is a very special day because... You smell that?
Yes.
You smell that?
Honky Tonk Man himself did a personal appearance here over the weekend.
Get your head in the game. This is serious toy business. He's not inside. But there's a very special collectible inside. Something I need, and I'm not worried about you buying it because you're cheap, Curt. See ya.
It's cautious, Curt. Don't you forget it.
Okay, here's a funny fact. Okay, so these are Last Action Hero action figures. It's this great, I say great, but it's not really a great Arnold Schwarzenegger movie.
Timeless to our childhood.
Right, right.
Yeah.
So this kid, Danny, Danny,
this is gonna get really weird.
Okay, so when I was a kid and I played with my WWE action figures, like I was the president, right? And at the time...
Commissioner.
No, I was like the president, like Jack Tunney.
Oh.
But I was the president, okay. You know what I'm
Even
saying?
More weird
so like
child,
Vince but... trusted me, like there was the WWE and then...
To make all the matches.
Right, yeah. But then there was the new WWE, that's where the elite guys went, and I was the president. Like Vince let me be the president. And this figure right here, this Danny, is who I used as young me in like 1996, 97, because I had that like JTT style haircut and... It looks just like me as a little kid. We could put in a picture of me as a little kid.
You just like, admitted that on camera, by the way. Oh my God.
And I'd buy this, but I already have two of them.
And you grew out that bowl cut like a couple years ago. You could put a clip of that in there too.
That was like Bradley Cooper. All right.
Bradley Cooper's ugly brother.
These best of ECW figures were by Jack Specific in what year? Like 90? No,
05.
No. 05?
Yeah.
It's definitely 05? Yeah, 05. And it was to depict the, it was almost like a vintage classic before classic.
Remember, classics were going on, so it was like a subdivision.
A subdivision.
Very.
And these were what the Dudleys looked like in ECW,
yeah,
which was cool.
Also, the One Night Stand show was going on.
But these weren't the One Night Stand
shows. No, but like, I think it was like, you know, ECW nostalgia was really,
right.
It's and always, there was, always big.
There was also a best of WCW. I'm just gonna pick these up. I'm gonna pick these up. I don't care if they're signed. Sorry, Bubba Devon, but I'm letting these breathe.
I mean, if you really want to sign, we can just get Devon to re-sign it for you at work.
That's true.
Found this. We're completely stumped together. Broski doesn't know. I'm not even bother talking to him about it.
Hey!
What?
Don't talk about me like that.
But I'm actually learning today. I'm trying to figure this out. I text Castro Sono because I feel like he could be the outside source to get some information. I know I'm gonna pick this up no matter what, because it's unique and it's moderately priced.
Get it out.
Well, yeah, learning something today. You can learn something every day, kids. Learn something new. Sofubi. That's Japanese for a toy. I don't know what I'm buying.
All right, that is a Genichiro Tenryu figure. The company has a couple different names. I don't really know what name came first, but there's Bullmark, there's Metacom, and there's Sofubi. Tenryu, master of the chop punch, he teamed with Koji Katao at WrestleMania 7 to take on Demolition. Those figures, I believe, originated with the Tiger Mask cartoon. in like the 70s. It's kind of like we had Mego Marvel action figures and they kind of retro remade a bunch of those. That's kind of what happened with these. There's Vader, there's Sting, there's Ultimate Warrior. So they're made in the design of these old Tiger Mask figures.
Yeah, we heard there's something very special here. I haven't found it.
Let's get eyes on it.
I know right now we're in Phoenix, but let's take a trip down to Cobb County, Georgia. Where is the big boss man?
Serving hard time.
Where is he? Take a trip down to Cobb County, Georgia. You better read the signs. Respect the law and order. You'll serve hard times.
You'll be serving hard times. Oh, wow.
There he is.
Dun, dun, dun.
The big boss man, Hasbro Tuup.
With the nightstick. What can you tell us about this?
So, as a child.
Oh,
and the drawing?
Yeah, the artwork. Oh my God.
The original blueprints are down there. So, as a kid, I've always been fat. Like, I was just a fat kid.
Right.
Big boss man was my childhood hero. I'd go to the barber shop with my WWE magazine and say, make my hair look like this guy. a few years ago, I met a friend of yours, Dan Killingsmith.
Yes.
And he introduced me to Ron Rudette.
Right.
Through email, and I was able to get the blueprint. And then about 6 months later, he found me the Tuup.
Wow.
So that is a childhood dream come true. Hasbro Bossman 1 was the last one in the series I could find. I looked all over. My grandmother took me everywhere. And I finally found it.
Very cool.
So and now I have that.
Now, is this for sale or is it just like on display?
It can be for sale.
Can we just look at it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Can you see that? So before, like, all the artwork was done, like, on computers, all the concept art, it was hand-drawn, literally hand-drawn. And can we see that artwork a little bit? Look at that. Get a shot of that. That is the hand-drawn Big Boss Man figure. This is before the computer days, where it was all done on a computer.
This is how it all started, you know? Just an artist and a conception.
1989. Look at that. That's
pretty cool.
That's beautiful. A beautiful piece. So really, these were supposed to be destroyed. Now, who is this signed by?
By Big Boss Man.
Oh, who's Joe? Who's Joe?
So
to Joe,
this,
Big Boss Man.
He gave it to Joe
at some point? It tells all about it.
This is a print master for a Big Boss Man figure. The paint masters were to show the actual colors and detail of the figure would be finished in production.
That's what I just said. Look at that.
It's double the size. I was an engineer on the WWE wrestling figure line. The boss man came to Hasbro for a visit, and I had him sign it for me. This was authentic signature as witnessed by me. And Joe, the infamous Joe from the back of the figure, signed it.
So these Tuups, they're meant to be destroyed. You know what I'm saying? So I think there's less than 20 out there known to man.
And there's like 70-something Hasbro figures.
Right, so in theory, every figure should have one. I think the later green cards never got them, only the heads.
Wow.
I think that's true.
Well, that's only the proof. That's just
right.
It's known.
So there's like, I think there's like 20 or so. I don't know the exact number. I have.
Speaking of numbers.
Oh, speaking of numbers.
You did say you'd sell it.
I would sell it.
What's the upwards?
Yeah, go ahead.
What are we looking for? He's got the goosebumps.
So if I sell it as a package deal, you get the blueprints with a letter from Ron Rudette, plus the Tuup with the letter from infamous Joe. I was asking
$8,500. Oh,
wow.
Nightstick's broken.
Well, yeah, I think that's why.
That's why it's, that's a fair price. It just.
And that's about what these things are worth.
Yeah, for sure. I have a couple of these in my collection.
That is cool.
Yeah, this is great. I think it's gonna have to stay here in Phoenix, though. This is, get a good shot of the boss man of me holding it.
It's time to buy an engagement ring, not a big boss man.
Oh, man. It is beautiful. Now, this one, like mine, the parts are super glued. Some of them, they come apart with like pins.
Yeah.
Which is like later on.
Yeah.
This is in great, shape for being what?
Piece of WWE wrestling figure history.
Over 25 years old. I'm not good with math. 2019.
You're 33.
1989. Yeah. So what's the math on that?
Subtract the 7.
you don't know either.
This is why we're wrestlers, folks.
almost 30 years old, and it's in great shape. Like, there's just, like, minor cracking there, which is nothing. Like, I had the Bushwhackers at one time, and it was cracking all down the arms and stuff, so I had to get rid of them.
I am open to a counter offer.
Whoa! You just got
it. My counter offer would be insulting to you. That's the problem.
I hear insulting offers every day, and I just smile.
How often people come in and like gawk at this or wonder?
I only brought it in this weekend because I knew you were out.
Oh, whoa, this is a setup.
This is the long con right here. No, I can't do it.
That's.
This will be the whole episode, just me here breathing, almost vomiting right here.
Counter offer.
I can't.
That's what I think it's.
Yeah, I know. It's a great piece.
Throw it at me.
All right, here's. Let me. this is the whole episode. I'll speak out loud of what I'm saying.
Go for it. This is an open forum.
Okay. I wasn't the biggest Big Boss Man fan. Like, you grew up with him, you loved him, you got your hair cut like him. I never wanted my hair cut like the Big Boss Man. Sure. I did love the Big Boss Man.
The man.
But with that being said, this is a beautiful two-up.
Mm-hmm.
I have other two-ups.
The condition is good.
I have two-ups.
Is that what's getting you?
The condition is great.
Yeah.
Here are the things that throw me off.
Okay.
The signature on the back. Not that I don't, I believe it's authentic, but I don't.
No one's gonna see that.
I don't care about Joe. Is this Joe? No offense, Joe. I just don't care about you. And the nightstick is broken.
But then you're never gonna. That's not like. That's not a fixable problem.
Right. Hypothetically, if I were to purchase this, not saying I will, I wouldn't have it displayed. I'd probably have it like down.
Or put it in his hand one time.
He can't hold it.
I think it would.
No, the stick is what's missing.
You could test it and see if it just sits.
No, it's too big.
Oh, too big. Oh, I see you're saying he needs that part.
It is nice. Man, Chelsea's gonna watch this and then she's gonna get so mad.
Like, she doesn't know you buy figures every hour, on the hour.
It's gonna be an insulting offer. I can't insult this man. He lets into his store.
He's open. He said he's all ears.
Hit me.
Yeah, let's go.
4,000.
4,000. I can go down to 6,500.
Yeah, I can't do that. It was worth a shot, though. It was worth a shot. It was worth a shot.
Last and final offer, and I have very good eyesight, and cell phones have great angles.
Yeah, I'm sure. Thanks.
5,500.
You saw.
I thought that was fair.
I'm not. No. All these offers are fair. The original price is fair. It's if I want to spend it.
Oh, all right.
And I. Well, how about this? If I put in 5,000, would you give me the 500 since you screwed me?
What? Why would I? And I get nothing?
You get nothing.
Oh, get out of here.
I'll give you the artwork.
I'm not gonna display that.
Well, it's all. Oh my God. I would do 5.
Whoa.
Well, here's the thing.
Oh.
5,500 is the exact cost of my family of six's annual
family. Oh, now I feel like the
six. That's a huge family. Oh my God.
Four kids ranging from 4 to 16.
They gotta go Disney.
Now we're saying 5,500, no tax, no BS, just 5,500.
Friends and family.
Friends and family.
No note.
WWE Universe, this is for you.
Oh, yeah.
I'm doing it for you.
Oh,
this isn't for me.
I'm so excited.
This isn't for you. For all my loyal fans out there.
Oh, so excited.
All right, 5,500. Friends and family.
Our friends at WWE.com.
Can our friends at WWE.com ship this home? All right, you guys have a deal.
Oh, man.
Oh, we gotta do it like this.
Oh, don't knock over the two-up.
All right.
Oh, baby. Hasbro King reigns supreme. I guess we don't have to worry about the tally this week. I don't think I'm going to come close.
Can't believe I just ate this.
Not for starting lineups.
Oh, man.
Okay. No, I got to pay the man.
All right. Oh, boy. All right, let's do this.
I put all my other purchases away, and I am only walking away with a Big Boss Man 2-Up and artwork for a grand total of $5,500.
See that? You see that? That's me sleeping on the couch for 5,500 nights.
I feel great. I'm spending a lot of money right now, but it's nothing. Nothing. Not compared to what just went down in here. Roski's so defeated he put stuff back. Never even heard of that. From him, at least.
Today I'm walking away with Royal Rumble 2010 Mattel Beth Phoenix figure, a Big Bird squeaky toy for my daughter, a 2005 Best of ECW Jack Specific Dudley Boys action figure, a Jax Classic Superstars Spike Dudley action figure, and a Safubi Tenryu Vintage Japanese action figure for a grand total of
$153.30. It's a lot less than Zach spent. It's a beautiful day here in Phoenix, Arizona. Spent $150. Roski, how much did you spend?
Shut up! Stop! I don't want to talk about it. Stop!
I blacked out. I didn't hear the final price of that.
I hate you, Hawkins. I hate you!
$500 at Collector's Marketplace? Are you serious, bro? That's gonna be 5,500 long, lonely nights on the couch. Woo, woo, woo. You know it.